Welcome in, everyone. Today's tutorial is focused on the Move It mod by Cuboid. While you may have familiarity with Move It, Move It 2.8 just released, and with that comes a slightly new design along with some new functionality. Within this tutorial, I intend to introduce Move It to new users, as well as dive into the new functionality and the new look of Move It. If you enjoy the video, be sure to hit the subscribe button down below. And if you have any feedback or suggestions, be sure to drop those in the comments. Additionally, if you'd like to see us building live, where we use Move It quite often, visit us at twitch.tv/slay3k. Now let's go ahead and dive in. Once you subscribe to Move It in the Steam Workshop and you've gone into Content Manager on your main menu and turned on the mod, Move It will then function when you load into your city. Once you're in your city, you'll notice a new icon, the Move It tool icon. You can move the Move It tool icon by right-click, holding, and dragging the icon to wherever you want to position on screen. Clicking the Move It tool button will bring up several other icons. First, we're going to talk about single selection. Single selection gives you the ability to select one asset in your city. You can relocate it, move it, adjust height, manipulate it. This includes network assets. By selecting nodes and segments, you can manipulate different networks. A network asset includes anything that you have to draw a path for. For example, roads, paths, or fences. And with this update, you can edit transportation pathways for ships, ferries, planes, and more. And with Sunset Harbor, you can also edit fishing routes. You just need to be within the transportation pathway view and have Move It open. Now as we move forward, let's discuss a helpful tip. Within Move It, you can use Ctrl-Z as a hotkey to undo a movement. Ctrl-Y will redo the movement. Next up, let's talk about the Marquee tool. The Marquee tool gives you the ability to select multiple assets of different types. You can highlight all these assets by clicking and dragging across the screen and creating a selection box. You can also filter the selection using the filter panel that pops up. First, let's talk about Picker though. Picker allows you to select an item using the eyedropper tool. So for example, here I'm selecting this tree. You'll notice on the filters panel that Move It now recognizes the tree as the item I'm picking. From there, I can only select assets of that type. So you can see as I'm doing a marquee selection, the only thing being highlighted are the trees. You can clear the picker tool by double clicking on the eyedropper. Now remember, whatever assets you have your filter set to are the only assets you're going to be able to marquee select. When you create a marquee selection, assets that are currently filtered will show up blue. Once they're selected, they'll show up green. If you double click on a specific type of asset, it will filter only to that type of asset. This is helpful when you're trying to limit your filters very quickly. Using the marquee selection filtering, I can also pick nodes and segments within network items. This makes it easier to adjust things like intersections or bends in roads or paths. The arrow at the bottom of the filter panel opens up a filtering system specifically for network assets. This can be really helpful when you have multiple network assets in a small area. So by choosing a specific network asset, you can then manipulate that type of asset. However, by picking paths, you won't be able to edit roads. Keep in mind, assets from the workshop may vary in terms of what category they fall under. Now let's talk about two other tools that Move It gives you. That's Duplicate and Bulldoze. They can be found to the right of the Marquee Selection tool. By selecting the asset and hitting the Duplicate button, you're able to create a copy of the asset. Keep in mind that duplicating the asset, you may get a variety of results in scale and color depending on the asset itself. One important feature to note is right-clicking with an asset currently hovering, you can rotate the asset at intervals within Move It. Or I can hold right-click and drag it to a specific rotation point of my choosing before placing the asset. You can keep duplicating an asset as many times as you want. To disable the duplication of that asset, you can hit escape. Now the next feature is Bulldoze. Much like you'd expect, that'll delete an item from your city. You can use the Marquee tool to highlight a set of items and then hit Bulldoze to remove them from your map. Now with Marquee selection, you can select a variety of assets all at once and position them wherever you'd like. You can copy those assets using Duplicate or delete them using Bulldoze. And because you're using the Marquee selection, you can filter and use these tools at the same time. Don't forget, you also have the ability of using Ctrl-Z to undo a duplication, as well as Ctrl-Y to redo it if you need to. Next up, we're going to talk about Follow Terrain and Toggle Snapping. These are helpful when trying to position assets. Follow Terrain forces an asset to follow the terrain height, instead of cutting into the terrain. Since the terrain already conforms to this building, you'll see that it'll still cut out a space. However, when Follow Terrain is on, the building simply adjusts to the height of your base terrain. Assets that don't require the terrain to conform could disappear under something like a slope, so keep that in mind. Next up is Toggle Snapping. This allows assets to snap into place on a grid system. Now you may be wondering where that grid system is. The toolbar extending from the right side of your screen has view options. The first one we're going to use is Toggle Grid View, which brings up the grid system. This can be really helpful when laying out props in a specific system where precision is key. With this panel on the right, you have two other options. In addition to grid, you have Toggle Underground View. This allows you to see what's underground, specifically network items like subways. I can then go in with MoveIt and adjust subway curves and nodes, much like I would any other network asset. This gives you a ton of flexibility underground to be able to have more precise control over network assets. Now, the next button we're going to talk about is toggle procedural objects. This option will only appear if the mod procedural objects is enabled in your game. When you select it and we go back to the marquee selection tool, you'll notice another option under the filtering panel. That is PO for procedural objects. This gives you the ability to select and manipulate assets that you have converted to procedural objects. This is an extremely handy option that brings us up to our next section of the tutorial, the toolbox. The toolbox is where most of the functionality of MoveIt exists. It's also been redesigned. And I bring this up now because within Toolbox, you're able to convert assets to procedural objects. So let's dive into Toolbox and see what functionality exists there. Toolbox is now divided into three categories: height tools, rotation tools, and other tools. You can hover over one of these three categories to open up the tools within. New icons have been implemented, and two new tools now exist within MoveIt. Those are the line tool and the set position tool. Additionally, import and export options for MoveIt are now relocated under the other tools option. First, let's take a look at the height tools. These are some of the most commonly used tools in MoveIt. Slope align works different than before. Now you can just highlight the assets or nodes you want to create the slope on. By hitting slope align, it automatically creates a slope between the two furthest assets. Next up, we have align to terrain. Since we don't have follow terrain toggled, you can see that when I move a prop, it disappears within a slope. But by utilizing the align to terrain tool, the prop will then align itself to the terrain height. The next tool would be aligning to an object height. First, select the asset you want to adjust the height of, the tool, and then the asset you want to match. Now let's talk about rotation tools. Under the rotation tools category, you have three options: rotate randomly, rotate at center, and rotate in place. Rotate randomly is going to take selected assets and rotate them at random intervals while remaining in their current position. You can do this by highlighting the assets and clicking the tool. Now moving down the list, we have rotate at center. Rotate at center works a little bit differently in that it's going to take assets and rotate them around a central point within your selection. So in this instance, the middle building is going to be the central point. Then we're going to align it to the road. That way they align themselves together and are properly placed against the road. Next up, we have rotate in place. This allows you to take a selected asset and orient it in the same direction that another asset is currently set up in. So first, select the asset you want to adjust, then the tool, and then choose the asset you want to adjust the first asset to. Finally, we have the other tools category. This has the most options, including convert to PO, line up objects, mirror objects, reset objects, set position, and it serves as a new home for import and export. So first, let's start with convert to PO. I'm going to select one of these rocks, which is a prop. I'm going to select convert to PO, and you'll notice that PO toggling automatically comes on. This is important so that you can actually maneuver the object using MoveIt. In the filtering panel under marquee selection, you'll also see PO selected. That means you can manipulate the procedural object much like you would a prop or building or any other asset in MoveIt. One way to tell the difference between a procedural object and another prop or building that is not converted to PO is that its highlight color will now be magenta. Now keep in mind, whether you convert the asset to a procedural object in MoveIt or in procedural objects itself, it'll still work with MoveIt as long as you have PO toggled. And you can see I can still edit the object using procedural objects. Keep in mind, not every asset will work with procedural objects. If the asset you selected to convert disappears, use Ctrl-Z to undo the operation. That may mean that the asset is not compatible with procedural objects. Next, we have one of our newest features being lineup objects. This allows you to select a series of assets and line them up evenly in a straight line. Keep in mind, MoveIt is not going to distribute the asset based on scale. The next feature we're going to talk about is mirror objects. So we have these rocks on one side of a network. You're going to need a network to be able to mirror. That designates a line for MoveIt to then mirror these objects. I'm going to select the rocks, mirror objects, then the network line in the middle, specifically the segment, and you'll see that the rocks are now mirrored on the other side of the road. You can then delete the network path if you don't want it there. Next is reset objects. Reset objects will take selected objects and reset them, repairing any damage or setting a new random color and size where possible. Next up, we have a new feature called set position. I'm going to take one asset and show you how this operates. By choosing set position, you're going to have another box come up. This is going to be your position box where you can insert coordinates for where you want your asset to move. You can adjust the x-axis, the y-axis, height, and angle of that asset. Inner values for each one if you'd like. Then by hitting go, we can see the change in the asset according to the coordinates I post. This gives you the ultimate control over being able to set an asset position in your city. Remember, You can't adjust the height of network segments, and you can only adjust the height of trees with the tree snapping mod enabled. Also, you cannot edit the angle of trees, network segments, or nodes within the set position tool. Finally, we have import and export. Many of you have probably used this functionality before. It's since moved into other tools, but the functionality remains the same. If you're unfamiliar with this, this allows you to save assets in MoveIt and re-import them into different cities or different places on your map. Keep in mind, this will not work with procedural objects, only props and assets that have not been converted. By selecting a series of assets, I can then go to Export, creating a selection that I can save. I'm going to name it, hit Export. That selection is now saved to reopen later. Now, if I go back to Import, I can re-import that exact selection and place it. Like I said earlier, this will work from city to city. It is not only limited to the map that you're currently on. There's two more options within the import panel. You'll notice the X, which will delete the saved asset combination from the inventory of your exported assets. We also have restore. Restore will actually paste the selection in the exact location it was exported from. Now, there's a couple of tricks that you need to know, especially when you're working in dense environments. If you have assets that have stacked on top of one another, it can be tough to select the bottom. Thankfully, there's a step over option. By tapping Control Tab at the same time, you can step through different layers of assets. You can also single select different items by holding Shift and dragging those items into place. This covers our tutorial for MoveIt. This was a deep dive into the new features, the new look, and new functionality within the mod for version 2.8. If you're interested in learning more about MoveIt, check the description below for the user guide. I'd like to say thanks to Cuboid for his assistance in creating this tutorial and providing updates to MoveIt. Additionally, make sure you support the asset and mod creators on the Steam Workshop. They give us an endless amount of new possibilities and functionality within City Skylines. And with that, be sure to hit the subscribe button on the channel. We'd love to have you back, and if you want to check out our live builds, visit us at twitch.tv/slay3k. If you have any feedback, be sure to leave them in the comments below, and I'll see you guys next time.